Hey guys, Jeff Belzer watching Living Coastal in Ventura. Today we're going to go over the front street and all the history of the changes that have happened in just this little two block radius and all the cool things that are happening. We're gonna go back about 10, 20 years, maybe a little bit further back. And we're gonna talk about all the different things that have happened from, you know, restaurants to new buildings to, you know, housing and really the hype that's going on in this area. So to start out with, go ahead and click the subscribe button if you haven't already so you can see more videos. And I'm gonna let you guys know, we are located in downtown Ventura. We are a stone's throw away from the water. You can see the water from here. You cross the train tracks. There's actually a really cool trestle that goes over the freeway right to the pier. And that's why this is one of the coolest areas of downtown Ventura, because it's literally on the cusp of midtown and downtown. So there is housing downtown and also in the midtown area. And when you come to this corner, this is Thompson and Ash, firstly made famous by Crowley's Burritos. Everybody always wants to get a good breakfast burrito or something to eat from Crowley's. It's a great grab and go restaurant. But what's happening is right now we've got Urban Cafe moving in across the street. And then we've got, I'm really excited because we've got Spencer McKenzie's Fish House right here. And what's a really cool story about Spencer McKenzie's is John, the owner and operator, he named the restaurant after his kids, Spencer and McKenzie, when they're little ones. And he started out with the food truck. He's one of, when food trucks were just starting to kind of get popular, you know, around, you know, the mid 2000s, he was doing a food truck at the California C Street Classic. But our focus is on Front Street. So we're gonna just walk and talk about what changes we've seen.
So what's really great about this area is all the restaurants that are popping up, but also these really cool, you know, over 100 year old homes that are really, they're really great to look at, and they're right here in the thick of it. All right, so we just spoke with one of the neighbors and she bought that place in 2009. And she told us about how it was a housing for the sun-kissed workers, as well as, you know, this being an oil town and how they used to have like a tanker over here. What's really cool about that place is now, you know, she's got a fourplex, a ton of storage and utility out the back, and she had bought it at the down market when it's totally dilapidated, but fixed it up real nice, like most of these homes. When we turn the corner, I'm gonna tell you about this other place. So right here is a really interesting part. We're basically on the corner of Front Street and Ash, and it's always been a little bit of a seedy area, but what's really neat is you have a train trestle, you have an overpass, and then you have a walkable path that goes over the freeway right to the pier. So in this intersection, you're basically connecting downtown with the beach and the ocean, and you're making it really accessible with that walking path right there. If you went a little further down, you could always cross on California Street as well, so you could do like a full loop. So what's really great, you know, in addition to, you know, the surf shop being here, a couple of restaurants, Malibu Boats, we've got the pet stores, we've got the wharf. We've got Frontside Cafe, which is actually, so Frontside, the surfing move, but it's also an Aussie menu. So from the chef's, you know, time spent in Australia, wanted to bring back that flavor so you can actually get, you know, meat pies or, you know, your favorite Aussie dish right there. They've got some really good, healthy, clean food, as well as, you know, great coffees to serve. So one of the surfers' favorite places to go into right after they catch some waves. Now, for later in the evening, you've got Transmission Brewery, elevated bar with windows going 360 around, so you can get views of the Channel Islands from this place. And you've got Topper's Pizza. So right here in this little two block area, and the period of only about 10 years has changed dramatically from being, you know, maybe just Jiffy Lube you know, tires and get your car fixed on to having all these really cool, you know, restaurants and things to do. Some people in Ventura would actually compare this to the funk zone in Santa Barbara. Okay, so Walden has been a staple in Ventura since I was a kid. Now, in the 80s and 90s, when longboarding was having its revival with all the new modern tweaks a shortboard brought to the table, that's when longboarding really had its resurgence and took off. Walden, Steve Walden was definitely a leader in that realm, but also one of the biggest innovators in all surfboard shapes altogether. He is world known and world renowned, and you can find Walden surfboards all over the world, and they're made right here in California. Yeah, nothing says Ventura like a combination of some Patagonia and something like Carhartt or Uggs from the Wharf. It's just right there. So we talk about old and historic homes, maintenance is key. As you can see, this Victorian behind me, workers have separated the door, they're prepping out the door, and they're repairing the wood areas that need repair, Bondo and whatnot, and then they're gonna give it that finished touch. So Boss Fit is really cool gym idea. Basically, it's like a combination or a hybrid of personal trainer and class. So they keep their class sizes really small so you get that personal attention, but you're also not paying the rates as if it was a personal training situation. So if you wanna check out a new gym, check out Boss Fit. So here we are in Transmission Brewery. And what's really great is that it opens up to Topper's Pizza. So you really have your selection. If you wanna come in here and have just a couple of beers, or you wanna get some pizza, you could do either or in both. So this rooftop bar is owned by Transmission. Of course, you can get some pizza and bring it on up, but they've got this really great 360 degree view. So we've got a view all the way out to the harbor over here. We've got just passing the pier, we've got Surfers Point. And what's really cool is Taylor Ranch, Grant Park. We've even got the homes on Calorama and Seaview Hills. All right, so we're concluding the end of the circle. We started out over at Spencer McKenzie's, went down Ash, came around Front Street, saw Front Side, Transmission Brewery, and Topper's Pizza. Now across the street, you have some really, really delicate cuisine with Cafe Zach's. There's not a lot of seating room there, so you probably want to make reservations or drop in on any weekday, and some really high quality food there. And then as we go down, you've got more of an experience is going to be at Barrel 33. All right, you guys, so that concludes our history of the Front Side area downtown. And just about two blocks radius, there's so much going on. There's so much change from different surf shops to restaurants, eateries, places to live, things to do, and being so close to the beach. Literally, you know, a half mile or a quarter mile just to walk down San Jose, or a quick walk across the trestle, and you're at the sand. I'm Jeff Belzer, and you're watching Living Coastal in Ventura. Remember to click that subscribe button and leave a comment down below.